Hi, welcome to Naresh IT. This is Kishore, and now I am going to give the example on destructors in inheritance. Okay, in previous sessions we have discussed how the constructor is working. Okay, I have given two examples for default constructor as well as parameterized constructor. Now I am going to give the example for destructors in inheritance. Okay, we have discussed that. Already we have discussed one topic. What is that? Default constructor of base class implicitly bind with the default constructor of derived class. Okay, default constructor of base class is implicitly bind with default constructor of derived class implicitly. Okay, due to this, what happens when derived class object is created? First of all, base class constructor is working. Later, derived class constructor is working. Okay, now the quite opposite manner, the destructor is working. The destructor of base class, the destructor of base class implicitly bind with the derived class destructor. Okay, it is important point. The destructor of, because of we are not having any default destructor, parameterized destructor, we are having only destructors, only destructor. Okay, that's why here the destructor of base class implicitly bind with derived class destructor. But here the point is constructor, okay, bind with the constructor in first line, means base class constructor bind with the derived class constructor in first line. But base class destructor is the last line of derived class destructor. Okay, remember this. Here the base class destructor, the base class destructor is the last statement of a derived class destructor. Okay, that's why first which one is executed? Derived class destructor is executed, later okay base class destructor is executed. That means the constructors and destructors are following stack concept, means stack LIFO concept, last in first out. Okay, last in first out, like this they are working. Now I am going to show you example for destructors. Okay, okay, first common header file hash include iostream.h, next hash include conio.h, next class I am going to create. For example, it is the base class. Okay, now I am going to create the base class. Okay, fine. Now the base class in public zone. Okay, we know that the constructor and destructor should be declared. The constructor and destructor should be declared in public area. That's why public area. And now I am going to start a destructor base. Okay, and we know that every destructor should have to start with okay, this complement operator generally we are calling. Okay, constructor with this operator is called what? Actually base function with this operator is called what? Destructor. Okay, tilde operator, generally it is known as tilde operator, everybody knows. That's why here base, base is the class name followed or preceded by, okay, preceded by tilde operator, which is called destructor. Now it is the destructor. Okay, later simple mechanism, means simple method I am going to write, cout base class destructor, okay, and that's all. Suppose I am going to write like this, and now the class is completed. See, this very simple class is there, class name base public, and here it is the destructor of base class, and it is having only one statement, base class destructor. Okay, fine. Now I am going to create derived class. Okay, it is the derived class, class derived public base class. Now the meaning is what? This class is derived, this class is derived from this base class. Okay, now it is the derived, and once again public. Okay, in public area I am going to write one more destructor of derived class. Okay, now it is called tilde operator and derived. Okay, now
tilde operator derived. It is called what once again? Destructor of which class? Derived class. Okay. And now here I am going to write some statement like this. See out derived class destructor. Okay. Here we can use slash n, either and both, no problem at all. Now close class, also close. Here watch this, it is the base class, base class having only one destructor. Now it is having base class destructor matter and derived class derived from base class, and it is having only one destructor. Okay, fine. Now two classes we are having. Okay, now what happened? Actually, when this class object is derived, automatically this destructor will become the last line of this program. Okay, when the object of derived class is created, for example, okay, it is the main. Now main function, okay, first CLRS here common thing. Now derived D, suppose it is the what? Object of derived class, object of derived class. Next bracket closed. Now what happened? Derived D is the object now. Okay. Now bracket is going to close. Means what? Now the block is closed. When the block is going to close, the destructors of derived class is working. Means what? It is working. Answer, derived class destructor. That's why first output is derived class destructor. Okay, fine. And next line. Now what happened? When this derived class destructor, means object, is going to close, here already base class is having a destructor now. Automatically it binds with the derived class destructor in last line. Means what? Here implicitly it is also added.